Hello, my name is Przemysław Rzepecki and I'm recording this in Stockholm, Sweden. Last week we implemented the Roman number converter, so we convert the Arabic numbers, the usual number that we are used to Roman notation. This week we'll run the conversion the other way around. See all the tests that we implemented last week. And let's start writing the new ones. So we change maybe the test case names, call it from Roman. And as before, we start with a single symbol. The simplest thing we can do is to check that the Roman number written as integer is equal to 1, and we choose the Roman number of I, simplest possible. And the compilation is failing. Need to change our code to write the new constructor. The new constructor should take the string as the input. And as a Roman number, our implementation of Roman number inherit from the string, so we can just put the argument to our constructor to the superclass. That will just copy all the string data. And we need to write a conversion from our Roman number to integer value. So for that, I wrote the cast operator. And to just make the test case pass, we return a 1. Now let's try to implement all other values of all the symbols that we have in the Roman number notation. So I add a few more assert equals to the test case. And we are changing all the assert to cover all the single letter symbols. Now the test case should fail. We always return 1. The symbol, well, we introduced a map to convert the integer numbers to symbols. Now we can use this similar map to convert the symbols to integer values. And not to duplicate the data, we could convert the first map to the second map. So let's use a dedicated function init for that. Get all the data and move it to the init function. And now we could go through, iterate through the symbols map. So we write the standard for loop. We use the auto notation to skip writing the long iterator expression. And in the values map, we should use the I second as a key, which was the value of the first map, and I first as a value, which was the key of the first map. And now in our integer cast operator, we can simply return the values based on our string. Of course, need to add the init. The test case is passing, so we are able to convert any single letter Roman number to Arabic number. The next step is to add those symbols together. So let's check that the Roman number cast to integer Roman number II will equal to, I guess that's the simplest test can do in this adding symbols, and it's unfortunately failing because the II is not in the map. You have just the single letters in the map. So let's iterate through all the letters in the string. Remember, we inherit from the string, so now the beginning and end functions will refer to the string that we pass to the constructor. And we of course just iterate through it, and for every single letter we will find its value in the map and add it to the sum. Now we need to just construct another string from this iterator to give us a single letter string. We just need to initialize the sum, and in the end we return the complete sum. So, set to zero, then we add, and finally we return. That seems to work fine for the simple test we have two. Let's check it for three and maybe eight. Some more complicated number. Okay, 678 should be DLXXOIII. And well, 3003 is 3 M's for 3000 and 3 I's for 3. This case is failing, seems I calculated the number incorrectly and the implementation is correct, so DC for 600. Yes, now it's correct. So we can move to the next test case, when we will check that we can also subtract some symbols from each other. So let's say the number 4 is the result of conversion a Roman number IV, and then the I is subtracted from the V to yield 4. Now let's think for a moment how we should fix it. We already have the IV in our map, but that will be the two letter string. So it seems that we first should check if the two letter string is in the map. So for that one we write values, count, we use the count function to check if something is in the map, and we check if the string of two letters, so string from the current position of the iterator to plus 2, is in the map. If it is, we should add its value to the map, so that will be the values, and then we use the string from I to I plus 2. Else we use the single letter, so that will be all the same, only I and I plus 1, which gives the one letter string from the current position of the iterator. That looks quite nice. We have quite many std string letters here. One, I just put the plus plus at the I, because when we use the two letter string we need to move our constructor an extra position forward. Since we missed the closing brace here. Now the syntax should be correct. That seems to work fine. At least for the number 4, we could check some few numbers. Now actually we should support any well-formatted Roman number. 9 and 999. That's good. Test case for subtracting. As well as 4394. As 90 will be CM for 900, XC for 90, IX for 9, and here to change it, I cannot write 4000, so 3494 will be mm, and then CD for 400, XC for 90, and IV for 4. Since our converter managed all the numbers correctly, we could say we are done. However, we should check if the Roman number, so the given string to our constructor, is a valid Roman number or not. There are many strings that are not valid Roman numbers, and then we should throw an exception to notify the user that something's wrong with the string. So for instance, if small letters are used, it should fail. Or if any other characters are used, we should cast an exception. Even the normal numbers, Arabic numbers, are not allowed Roman symbols. So now we need to add some checks to our constructor. However, we need to iterate through all the symbols to check that they are valid. So it might be good to put this check in this operator init function. And then we will call the operator init from the constructor. So whenever we construct a Roman number, we validate that it's possible to convert it to integer value, and we add the checks in the init operator. Let's move the check into the for loop, as we will need to validate every character in the string. So we should check that this current character, so the string from I to I plus 1, is in our map. And right now I realize that we have really a lot of this standard string I plus 1, so maybe we can replace it or have a variable for this. Let's call it just S for one letter string. So we check that values count of S is non-zero, and otherwise we will cast exception with text illegal symbol. And then I can also replace this string II plus 1 in another place. So let's do it. It will maybe be a bit easier to read. And of course we need to implement our check function. This function will take the condition that we would like to verify and text that we can put in our exception. So whenever condition doesn't hold, we will throw exception, and let's use the standard invalid argument exception to our string. So we have the check values count is non-zero, and then yeah, of course we should validate whenever exception the condition doesn't hold. Yes, now all these invalid symbols are casting exception. However, that's not the only way the Roman number can be incorrect. Let's say if we have a four-time repetition, that should also be invalid number. So now we need to add another check, and let's check that the value of the iterator must be different of any of the three next letter in the string. So the value of our iterator should be different from next one or the next one. So that would be I plus 1 plus 2 plus 3. One of them must be different from our I value. And we can adjust the text in the exception. That hopefully should work fine. So now we are catching an four times repetition. However, some of the symbols, let's say V, D, and L symbol, cannot repeat more than once. So those that are stands for five cannot repeat more than once. So we check now that either our string is different than VLD or the next letter is different from the current one. That's okay, the string is different than V, L, or and D. Or if it's one of V, L, and D, the next letter is different than the current one. And that will be the also illegal repetition. The test case is working fine. And then it's also not valid to write a bigger value after a smaller one. So if we have I and M, that will also be illegal sequence. So we should always write the Roman number from the biggest symbol to smaller ones. So let's check. We will I add just the integer previous value, and then we can have the current value that we might compare. So now this, instead of directly adding to sum, we save it in the integer current, and we check that either we don't have an previous value, so that will be the first symbol when we initialize the previous from zero. Otherwise, the current value should be more than previous value, the illegal sequence. Should be the integer. And we of course need to set the last to current after the check, and then increase our sum. failure. In the test case, that doesn't cause the exported exception. Let's jump back to the implementation, verify that check. So we either have no previous values, so previous starts from zero, or when we have the last value, the last value should be more than the current one. More or equal to, since I have this more or equal sign the other way around. That should be the less or equal. So Roman numbers goes from the highest value to smaller one. Current should always be less or equal than the previous one. Now seems to work fine. So let's validate some other numbers that might fail or that should fail. All of those are not valid Roman numbers. Okay, let's verify that we catch them all, and seems to work fine. Actually, the adding the check for correct Roman number seems to be most difficult part of the exercise. Took us quite much time, but now we have the implementation is not that complicated. The Roman number is really interesting exercise. Well, thank you for today. See you. Bye.